students, today we'll be doing note making, which comes in reading skills section of your question paper. Well, note making basically involves noting the main points of whatever you read or hear, as one cannot be expected to remember all that one has read. So, we can say that note making is not just about writing down everything you hear or read. It is a process of reviewing, connecting, and synthesizing ideas from your lectures or reading. You know, note making is an advanced writing skill, which is acquiring increasing importance due to the knowledge explosion. So, in order to remember main points of any given subject, learning the skill of note making is a must. You must know about the kind of passages you get for note making. Well, the note making passage could be factual or discursive type. A factual passage is the one which provides good clarity on the topic being discussed. The whole passage gives the reader a complete picture of what is being presented. It gives a comprehensive view about the subject discussed by offering a step-by-step description of the same. Whereas, a discursive passage has less ambiguity, which means the passage will talk about various topics at random that appears to have no connection with one another. And moreover, these passages are generally of 550 to 600 words in length. You must be aware of the marks breakup in note making. The note making passage in the examination carries 8 marks, wherein it consists of 2 type of questions, note making and summarizing, 4 marks each. Summarizing is a brief summary of the main points taken up in the notes. Let's go through the marks distribution in note making first. In note making, title carries 1 mark. Use of abbreviations or symbols carry 1 mark. Minimum 4 abbreviations or symbols can be used. Content carries 2 marks, which consists of 4 headings and subheadings with proper indentation or spacing, thus making a total of 4 marks. So this was the first part of the question. Next is the summary. Summary carries 4 marks. Summary is basically the condensed version of the passage. So, the word limit of summary should be 80 to 100 words. That is about 1/3 of the passage. Let's go through the instructions which you need to follow while making notes. First of all, give a suitable title to the passage. The title should be short, precise, and relevant. Never pick a long sentence as a title. Begin the title with capital letter. It can be a single word or phrase. Refer to the picture given beside. The title is Artificial Intelligence, Not a Threat. So we can say that this particular title reveals the spirit and strength of the passage. And moreover, it is short and precise. Now coming on to making notes. So how can we make good notes and write a good summary? So for that, read the passage thoroughly and underline the main points and keywords. The notes should be short, precise, and to the point. So always remember, complete sentences are not accepted as notes. In such cases, half or one mark may be deducted from marks awarded to entire content. So avoid writing long sentences. Instead, stick to very short phrases. In fact, you can also avoid using examples, articles, or prepositions. Use only relevant and important information in logical order. Divide the passage into headings and subheadings. Minimum 3 and maximum 4. The title should not be repeated. In the picture, you can see we have 4 main headings with 3 to 4 subheadings. Now coming on to decide on a number system. Numbering of points may be indicated in different ways, as long as a consistent pattern is followed. See the picture, how the numbering is done. A consistent pattern is being followed. And also check the indentation in the notes. It means leaving space at the beginning of the line. First write the title and then write down the notes in a logical order. From the main headings to the subheadings, the numbering should be spaced a little to the right. For more clarity, you can go through the given picture and see how subheadings are slightly shifted towards the right. Next is, always use abbreviations in the notes. Minimum 4 and provide key for the same at the end. Lastly, make sure summary does not exceed the length of the original text. Summary carries 4 marks, so it should be grammatically correct and cover all the important points given in the notes. Let's have a quick glance on some of the symbols and abbreviations which we can use for note making. Basically, abbreviations help in writing the information briefly. So you can see the symbols and abbreviations given here. For percentage, you can see. For government, you can see. And so on. In fact, you can make one on your own, as you would be giving a key to the abbreviations in the end. So, this was all about note making. I hope you have understood it well.